as a brick. Probably in my normal voice. Parts of it. Mongrel dog soils actor's foot. The cameras were rolling. Film actor Robert E. Levi was addressing his men in the making of his new film, Biggles and the Snake Women, when a mongrel dog soiled his foot. The dog belonged to Japanese makeup artist Tatu Tuyu. Recently became resident in St. Cleve. He explained later, poor Poopsie was taken short. Head injury. 52-year-old Sarah Pickles of the High Street in St. Cleve cut her head when she tripped over while walking in the High Street. Badger Knee Roberts on December 25 at Victoria to Wendy and Cyril, a daughter, Fiona Fanny. Grateful thanks to all concerned. Coming of age. No, that's not that good. In memoriam. Beer. Vera. Vera beer. In loving memory of our dear niece called suddenly to rest, December 25, 1969, from Auntie Mavis and Uncle Boris. A quiet thought, a private tear, brings her memory so very near. On Christmas in here. They all say December 25. Reed, on December 25th, at Linwell Hospital, peacefully after not much suffering. Daisy, age 99 years, dear wife of Hercules. Norman exposed. Norman Smythe Royal, a local businessman, was found guilty of indecent exposure in the lower High Street on St. Cleve on August 14th. He asked for 44 similar cases to be taken into consideration and was fined a total of £400 and sentenced to 4 months imprisonment. He was also ordered to pay £14 witnesses' expenses. Uncle David drops in. Uncle David Palmer will soon be in town again for his annual children's musical party in the Town Hall Assembly Room. Police hunt. Police are investigating the theft of 12 assorted dwarfs, 4 full-size emperor penguins, a gnome in fishing position, and 2 Tweety bird baths from the garden of R. Black, 28 Church Street, Linwell. Man threw bottle. Unemployed farm worker Albert Innes, age 42, was arrested after disrupting a lecture meeting of St. Cleve on Tuesday night.
Tuesday.
It was alleged that Mr. Innes threw the bottle after taking exception to certain comments made by lecturer Andrew Jorgensen, DSC, concerning the intellectual stability of the working classes. The case comes up next Saturday at Newmarket.
I don't know. I can do quiet this time.
Good.
Hubba hubba. Hubba hubba.
Hubba hubba. Schoolboy goes it alone.
Oh.
Schoolboy Dennis Small took advantage of his position as sole pupil of Form 4A, at St. Cleve Comprehensive School during the recent flu epidemic to pursue his studies and gain a lead in his classmates. On his classmates, rather. As a result, during the end of term examinations last week, he came first in his class. His mother, Sarah Small, 48, attributes his resistance to the bug, to the fact that the whole family are nature lovers and seldom wear clothes in the summer. Cash for noise. Detailed proposals for a compensation scheme for people suffering from aircraft noise are to be submitted by Linwell Rural Council. Sandcastle Man calls it a day. Derek Pike, 39, of Small Close, St. Cleve, plans to give up his favorite hobby next month when he marries Angela DeGroot, 17, of Linton House. Fortin LaGrange, as a matter of fact. Mr. Pike is, of course, the famous Sandcastle Man who has won many competitions over the years on beaches all over Britain. He plans one final work before giving up the gay bachelor life. On the next exceptionally low tide at Bosworth Cove, he will attempt again his scale model of Buckingham Palace. Stiff, subtitle. He is particularly fond of the beach there, since the sand is stiff, firm, and pleasant to the touch. Angela will, of course, be there to give him a hand, and he will be taking the Pipe children by his earlier marriage to observe his astounding feat. Non-rabbit missing.
The non-rabbit.
One of an exception, rather an experimental batch of non-rabbits is believed to have escaped from the van on the Linwood. team of volunteers hunted for it in vain for several hours. Experts think it may be hiding. The public are requested to be on the lookout for the non-rabbit in the St. Cleve-Linwell Heath area and should notify the police immediately if spotted. Rabbit man Dr. Farley Ruskin commented that it is extremely difficult to tell a non-rabbit from a real one, but the non-rabbit gives off, when excited, a glandular secretion with a musky odor, which can be harmful to male donkeys and women with sensitive skin. The non-rabbit is thought to be a source of a possible cure for cancer in chimpanzees and rodents. It was revealed last month, lo and behold. Shopping boots. At last, someone has had the good sense to design a utilitarian boot for winter wear. No more cold hands as you struggle through Christmas shopping. Conveniently designed to hold up to a 2.5 cubic foot of shopping in each boot. These cold weather cuties by local designer Maria Quad look like the answer, with matching coat trimmed and lined with non-rabbit fur and the latest French earmuffs and nose mask. Be ready for admiring glances from the grocer. Yet not available in the West End. This outfit, by special dispensation, to shortly be on the sale at the Brass Knob Boutique in St. Cleve. Sweet Tooth Thief Find. A former convent schoolgirl who stole 4 dozen eggs and sweets from a supermarket storeroom was fined £40 by St. Cleve magistrates on Monday for theft. Scorpio.
You start with that one.
This week, Well, this was in 1972, October 23rd, November 21st.
Hmm.
This week, you may feel the benefit of Venus in your sign.
Mm-hmm.
Business prospects receive an unexpected bonus. However, you need to get out and about more. Tackle everything with sparkle. A time when Cupid takes a back seat in your love life. Virgo. August 23rd to September 22nd, 1972. A challenging week for businessmen, but probably having unexpected profits. A few interesting trips will indicate, rather are indicated. And you will tackle everything with zest. However, your romantic side may need to be curtailed during the week. Best clothes. Several weeks ago, I wrote in the town clerk about the condition of the five places in St. Cleve in which water was lodging in gullies because of the lack of grates and bad alignment of the gullies. I suggested that the surveyor's department should come out of their offices when it rained and see for themselves. If someone ruined their best clothes through being splashed by vehicles and claimed damages, we might get something done. As for Cowan Hasty, if he were out that one night, he may not think that we were impudent then. Considering the amount of new houses built and under construction in St. Cleve, the building in public toilets is a must. Rather, of public toilets. We are not impudent, considering the amount of rates we pay. Still frustrated, these small of St. Cleve. Thanks, say the readers. Just to show they are not critical unless there is a good reason, members of the Linwell Heath Chamber of Trade Executive Committee decided on Monday to send a thank you letter to the St. Cleve District Council for the manner in which a difficult operation had been carried out. That didn't have anything to do with what I thought of.
Oh, really? Oh, really? Oh, really? Oh, really?
I may all get naked soon.
Oh, really? Oh, really? Oh, really? Oh, really? Really? Oh, really?
Situation's vacant.
What situation?
Alan and Eric require a bright young male hairdresser for their high street salon. Excellent prospects for the right young man. Write with photograph or telephone to St. Cleve 69871. Careful women for washing up in small tea shop. Thursday and Friday, 2:30 p.m. to 5:30 p.m. at St. Cleve. 38072. Do you smile a lot?
Never.
Barmaid required. Energetic, experienced, and happy. For busy lunchtime trade. Must be able to work weekends. Apply to Mr. G on the White Swan, High Street, St. Cleve.
Oh, I better go for that chance.
Experienced snabbler. Needed for up-to-date office. Must have good audio touch aptitude for figure work, essential. Appropriate training given in labbing for further details applied to these small in care of Fort Fields Farm on the Telegraph, St. Cleve.
Really?
General health, ex-army officer wanted for assistance in many tasks. Call Miss A. DeGroote, St. Cleve, 89855. Plater for small local garage, good incentive with merit rates. Pension scheme with free life insurance. canteen and other advantages. St. Cleve 86942.
Marilla.
Raymond requires models for his new model school. Well, the rest of it's boring. Retired stewardess has vacancy in her gymnastic club for any sound men. Circus clowns outfits may be worn.
Yeah.
Hot showers available after the sessions. Urgent. Can anyone recommend a reliable, experienced gardener on a full-time or part-time basis? Please write to Charters Farm, Linwell Heath.
Alrighty then.
Brief intermission was at hand, brothers and sisters.
Oh. Excuse me?
Sorry for the dilly-dally.
Say what?
Hey.
Say what?
Bear with me, brothers and sisters.
No. Not today. Maybe tomorrow.
Be too late.
Not today, no bearing. No bearing today. No bearing with Kurt today.
St. Cleve Lady Rangers Association at the White Swan Hotel in St. Cleve. That was on Thursday.
When?
Thursday.
When?
Thursday.
When?
Thursday. Color films, which were accompanied by a soundtrack and music, were called Boy with a Kite. which was filmed on the heath in the quarry.
Where?
Which showed the old quarry to the south of St. Cleve. It also included some dramatic film sequences of dog handlers at work. He thanked the local constabulatory. Constabulary, really. For their help with this. Mr. Thrower was introduced to Mr. Al Sake and then thanked by Mr. K. Vaughn.
Hey.
Just reached for my empty tankard.
Excuse me? Excusez-moi, monsieur. Comment allez-vous? Très bien, merci. Et vous?
It was a puncture, says Trenchin. Alleged Hell's Angel Richie Trenchin was acquitted on charges of being in possession of a bicycle chain, a sharpened spanner, a sawn-off spade, and a length of rubber tire today. By the way, tire is spelled T-Y-R-E.
Ah.
That was a Eli Assisi's.
Eli.
Or, let me try it again. Eli at, well, no,
Eli
Assisi's, yes, said Richie. I was on my way to mend a puncture on my bike, honestly.
He's lying.
Yes. Now, for encores. We shall see what we missed.
I want to start swinging. Hubba hubba. Hubba hubba.
Tull LP. Although not in the shops yet, I was able to acquire a white label pressing of the current Jethro winner Thick as a Brick from their London agents, Chrysalis Artist. The boys had recently returned from yet another tour of the U.S. When are we going to see them perform here, somebody says. And then they dashed into the studios and cut the spine waxing for the underground market. The group consists of Ian Anderson, Martin Barr, John Evan, Jeffrey Hammond Hammond, and Barrymore Barlow. Written around the poem by St. Cleve child prodigy Gerald Bostock, their music spins a delicate web of sensitive sounds, sometimes lilting, somewhat soaring, and sometimes soaring, to form a brilliant backdrop for the meaningful lyrics and improvisational techniques. Although I was unable to contact any of the group, busy lads, I met to talk on the telephone to Terry Ellis of Chrysalis, the executive producer of the album. Mr. Ellis told me that apart from a short orchestral passage, the members of the group played all the instruments themselves, in addition to his usual flute, acoustic guitar, and singing roles. Ian Anderson extended his virtuosity to violin, sax, and trumpet, while Martin Barr played a few lines on the delightful medieval instrument, the lute, as well as his electric guitar. John Evan played organ, piano, and harpsichord. Jeffrey Hammond Hammond played bass guitar and spoke some words. And new drummer Barrymore Barlow added the timpani and percussion parts. One doubts at times the validity of what appears to be an expanding theme throughout the two continuous sides of this record, but the result is at worst entertaining and at least aesthetically palatable. Poor or perhaps naive taste is responsible for some of the ugly changes of time signature and banal instrumental passages linking the main sections, but ability in this direction should come with maturity. Taken on the whole, however, this is a fine disc and a good example of the current pop scene attempting to break out of its vulgarisms and sometimes downright obscene derogative hogwash.
Really?
Derivative hogwash.
Oh, really?
Not blatantly commercial then, but a fine disc, which although possessing many faults should be well enough, and it is out February 18th, 1972. Fun with Fennel. As an accidental spectator at last Saturday's game of Fennel on St. Cleve Recreational Park, I would urge all non-sports enthusiasts to take a close look at this recently revived local game. Though personally I take little interest in sports of any nature, I would strongly recommend this game to young and old alike. It is a sport not only for the rich people and trendy middle class, but one which can be enjoyed by the down-to-earth folk, like myself. So come to St. Cleve and have some good honest fun with Fennel, Mrs. Eileen Thatcher. Paper Chase ends. Maybe these aren't just encores, but they're additions as well. A bundle of assorted Sunday newspapers found on a seat of Tramlett Square in St. Cleve's on Sunday mystified St. Cleve news agents and police this week. They were found by Mr. G. Hunt of the Swan Hotel with the words, "Please distribute among the inhabitants of this town." Anonymously scrawled on the top, but none of the news agents in St. Cleve had received complaints that papers had not been delivered, so the mystery deepens. The story appeared on local television, and now part of the mystery is solved. The papers belong to news agent Mr. Archie Grimdale of Archie's Stores. The Sunday papers are too heavy for the paper boys to carry all at once.
Aww.
He explained. So I leave the bundle for them to use when they run out. We thought someone had just thrown them over a wall. He said, the bundle has never disappeared before. The search for them proved fruitless. As unknown to Mr. Grimdale, the 44 papers were miles away in St. Cleve. Now part of the mystery remains unsolved. How did they get there?
Yes. Look.
Sorry, Sasha.
Hubba hubba. Hubba hubba.
Sale. A big selection of fuels and accessories for home and workshop. Buy now for spring. A lawnmower. Don't let it rust this winter. Have it serviced before you put it away. Blunt tools. Have them sharpened or reset. Open all day Saturday. Baby buggy. Daniel of St. Cleve, our stockist. It can be carried like an umbrella. Ideal for air travel.
Okay.
Bicycles. Bought and sold, all sizes, from 550 pounds, rather $5 to 50 pounds, or 5 pounds and 50 cents. Part exchange.
Bicycle.
A kind camera. Make those home movies you've always wanted.
Yes, make them.
Camera, projector, screen.
Yeah.
Cultivators for hire. Delivered reasonable rates. Dwarf for rent.
Yes.
Dwarf for rent.
Yes.
Contact Derek
Dwarf
Small.
For rent.
£5 for a short session.
Dwarf for rent. £5.
And larger.
And larger. £10.
Two and one fourths by 35 millimeters.
Ooh.
Barely used. Such as mine. Exotic flowers for all the occasions.
Ooh.
Contact the flower garden. 76 High Street in St. Cleve.
Uh-huh.
4 reupholstered oak frame dining chairs. £3.50 each. Also handmade oak occasional table at £10. Test your wits. Solution. Derek's mother set out at 24 minutes to 4. It takes 14 minutes to walk from Derek's school to his home. French. 14th century letters of a French count for special collectors only. Lady Parrot at the Parrot House. Give it to her for Easter. Pastel.
Give it to her, baby. Dun, 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 dun.
Pastel mink.
Give it to
your
baby. Da 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 da. Give it to your baby.
Well,
thank
you.
Da 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 da. Give it to your baby. Da 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 da. Give it to your baby.
Home extension.
Da, da, da.
Made to measure. Erection service. Call and see our show models.
Okay.
Lady retiring to nursing home must dispose of 4 full-size stuffed emperor penguins. Perfect condition. Magnificent boy cycle. 20-inch wheels, suit boy 2 to 3 years. Nylon made to measure nylon wear. All requests considered. Be explicit in your requirements.
Hey. Hey.
New Zealand, not Australia.
Hey.
Gentleman gives instructions, and then I flip it around and it says, in head and hand standing.
Hmm.
Ore pots for sale. Believed to have been owned by royalty. 2 handles, 3 feet, but must not be left alone for periods of more than 4 minutes. Very quiet bargain for £444. Our compost will give you better results. Order now from Four Fields Farm, St. Cleve. Yar, Sasa. for a converted four-sided flatch. So can be used as fold-away, in parentheses. In full stereo, but unfortunately is not portable. Contact Lionel. Poultry and livestock. Aberdeen Angus, 44. Aberdeen Angus penguins, not sheep. Up for sale, not yet fully matured. Promises to be an excellent breeding badge. 4 pounds a head. Produce. Your own fresh brown eggs. 5 pullets. No number too large or too small. This particular point, my friends, I bid you adieu till we meet again.
Okay.
All right. Somebody stole the clapper from the bell tower.
Yes, man.
Gas man.
Gas man, I didn't know, I wasn't expecting the gas man today.
Hello ma'am, come to read your meters.
All right, they're back here. Yeah, I'm here.
Oh, I was wondering. Thank you.
You're welcome. Well, make sure you get it right. I don't want to be overcharged, you know.
Oh, no. I wouldn't worry about that.
All right. Write that down right.
Yeah. I'll do my best.
Okay.
might get snow, huh?
Yeah, that's what they say. I hope not.
Me too.
Yeah, you're outside a lot, huh?
Oh, yeah, yeah. This time of year, it's particularly hot. Okay, I don't know if anybody told you, but I gotta inspect your chimney. I'm a part-time chimney sweep. So, let me, the meter's fine, and you're all set. We'll bill you. So, let me see how your furnace is working. And maybe we can see what we can do.
All right, I appreciate it.
Oh, no problem, ma'am. Oh, is that the heat?
Yeah, that's it.
Oh, my Lord.
Oh. Does it sound like it needs working out?
Oh, it might, yeah. Pardon my fumbling in my accent from time to time. Okay, I'll be right back.
Okay.
Yeah, it's snowing a little bit now. Oh, yeah. Oh, you got a Gibson washing machine. Those are hard ones to wait. Oh, Lord. I don't want to open that because, well, I just don't. But I can tell by looking up here, by the filter, whether or not there may be a problem. See.
Well, if there is, fix that.
Oh, yeah. I'll do my best.
You look like you know what you're doing.
Oh, yeah. I got the image, man. But I got to work on my skills.
Oh, you must.
Okay, everything looks like should be in order. Okay, I thank you for your time.
I thank you. How often should this be done?
Probably, this is tricky, man. I feel like Eddie Murphy and another professor.
Yeah, I should have warned you about those doors. Yeah.
Every 3 months. So, you'll be seeing me again.
All right, I'll see you in about 3 months.
Okay.
Well, he seems like a nice chimney sweep. Okay.
Yeah. talking to myself. There's nobody around to talk to. I sound like something out of Amos and Andy. My Coleman Young impersonation. My flashlight. I help raise the money for the Cobo Arena expansion and the people moving in the fast city of Detroit. I am Mayor Coleman Young. I forgot the rest. Oh, Lord. Look over here. Miles an hour. This is dog manure. Needs new batteries. Write myself a note before I forget. Flashlight needs new batteries. I say it to myself. I'll be moving along now. Take care. I gotta find me another meter. Gas man. This one. Oh, my leg. Temperature compensated. Bones in my thumb cracked. It's getting cold. The accident's getting thicker. Thank you. my business here is over. Wonder where I can go now. You know, hop that fence. Yes, man. 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 Don't manure. Yes, man. Yes, man. I guess nobody lives. Oh, it's a shed. Oh, that's my fault. Oh, Lord, I'm getting seen out. Oh, there's the house. Oh, I gotta look in there a few spots. I've already done checked their meter. I'm finna go look in that view spot. Gas man. Gas man. See two cars, I wonder if anyone's home. Gas man. Gas man. Gas man.
Door is open. Oh, Eddie.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, my God.
Yes, ma'am. Hello. Yes, ma'am.
Hi.
I just read your meter.
What's wrong?
Oh, it's fine. Everything's fine. It's just that I have a sudden desire to look at your fuse box.
You have a sudden desire to look at my fuse box?
Yeah, no? I don't have nothing better to do except talk to myself in the third person.
Well, come on
and
in.
I thought that I would just come in and see if your fuses is okay.
Well, come right in.
Oh, thank you.
Maybe you know where it is. I don't have any idea.
You live here alone?
No, just moved in over the summer.
Ah. Well, it's a big place, Lord. Oh, is that the heat? I hear the heat. Oh, but it's just an illusion. Feel heat here. Let's see, where do I go? Oh, I know, I got an idea. I got a fuse box detector out in the car.
Oh, that's a good idea.
I'll be right back.
All right. Boy, I didn't know gas men made house calls nowadays. Jeez, I wonder what he's doing out there.
This might work. Let's see, where is that fuse box? Somewhere in here.
you found it. Good job.
Do not energize water heater, circuit, until water heater is filled. I had a sudden desire to look at the old style fuse box. This is a little modern. I think I'll be going. It looks fine. Oh, I better write something down. I wonder if I got my pen and my paper in my pocket. I better write. Tongue twister, one of the few. Pen and paper in my pocket. This panel board shall be connected by a feeder assembly having overcurrent protection rates at not more than 100 amps. Other than that, it looks fine. When was the last time you had your chimney sweeped? I noticed you had a fireplace.
Oh, probably last winter.
If we get in that time of year.
Yeah. Do you feel like checking it for me?
Well, let me change hats.
All right.
So to speak,
okay.
And I'll see what I can do.
Okay, I'll wait here for you.
All right.
Oh, there he is. Oh, I guess he is prepared.
Trying to get my tools, and there was some soot in the back of my truck from the last job I did.
Oh my gosh.
And I stumbled and I face down right in it. I couldn't avoid it.
Oh my gosh.
I guess it suited my image though, huh?
I guess.
Oh, you got a nice one. Yep. What were you going to say, ma'am?
I forgot. Go ahead.
Oh. I brought my bellows.
Alright.
And my broom. Oh, you got a set similar. Where's your broom?
I don't know.
Oh, well, I got my broom.
Probably lost it.
Let's see here. I'm going to check this. Make sure you're all set for the winter. My voice echo in the fireplace.
Oh my gosh.
How about that? Ooh. Hello, Mr. Raccoon. Can you hear me? How about that? Oh, there's some soot. Some soot came down.
That's some soot.
You got some pitch up there. Yeah.
I got some pit and some soot.
Yeah. Let me get under here.
Oh, watch your head.
Well, that's why I got my stovepipe hat. Hello? Oh, boy. There we are.
Not hard to work on?
Not too hard to work on. I see it ain't a Gibson, though. It's got to be a Gibson.
Oh.
Then it's the ultimate fireplace. Sure everything's secure.
I reckon there's a technique to that.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you. What's that?
Van Wyck. Give you this broom here. Looks like we'd go good with your set.
Oh, thank you.
I got several in the truck. Well, now. Make sure it's just right here.
Okay.
When I do this kind of work, it kind of makes me want to talk in a proper English accent.
Well, I'll be darned.
So, at any given moment, I could break out into my. Well, I think it's done.
I see it coming.
Now I see that everything is in order. No. I'm not quite certain. I can't seem to. I'm always apt to sound. Sound like Matt Coleman Young, even though I try to sound like a Cockney English as much as I want to. So.
Hey, what can you
I
say?
I got that list down today for some reason. Don't know what it is. Maybe, there's a pipe up here. Maybe if I put the pipe in my mouth.
Maybe that's it. Well.
I can't do it. I still can't do it. I guess I'll call myself a fool and just steal these wooden teeth of yours and I'll be on my way.
All right.
You have a good day.
Well, thank you.
All right.
Bye. He sure is a strange one.
Yeah, I'm trying to find three things. I wonder if you might have them. I'm trying to find a can of Smith Brothers cough drops, or a plaque, or a poster, or, you know, a bottle, or some kind of, you know, advertising with the Smith Brothers cough drops. And also a stovepipe chimney sweeper's hat from the 1800s that Abraham Lincoln would wear. You know, just a foot and a half high or something like that. I've got one of the standard sizes. And also a poster or a plaque with George Washington smiling with wooden teeth. All his wooden teeth wired together individually. I wonder if you might have any of those things. Okay, I'll wait. Anyway, okay then. Spontaneity. Trust in my nose, maybe, maybe not. You can't come forth with an unbidden amounts of one's flam-tamil and can piddle. I can piddle. We always go back to Fang Tootle Rhymney, you see. We're stuck with that, you and I. And 4 and 6 cases of vinegar do not lay there. No reason at all. You see, we must all turn together to chapter 55 from the Mycinicide Bombardment Dictionary. You see, there's no other way around it. Give me one's confutile proceedings at once. Roll me over in the wind. Put me up under one's butterhead. And thwart me immediately to the wind. Until I am totally overloaded. But ran, stan, hibble, ban, can't man. Simply no other option whatsoever. Lay down with me in the Styx of confutile proceedings at once. Throw me over the river bend. And please, don't ever let Sir Timothy's mud iron play such an important factor. One's overriding constabulatory. You see, I came down with my steed, playing my fife, and walking my Alsatian all simultaneously. Where does that lead, brothers and sisters? For it isn't just happenstance. In fact, I have a sudden desire to reach for my immediate book on various subjects, if you will bear with me for one moment. We'll turn immediately to the Dictionary of American Slang. 1960, and see what it was all about, as it were. Make that 1955. I guess the mustiness of the pages. bones. An excessively thin animal or person. Bamboozle. To deceive or cheat by a hoax, to practice fraud and trickery. Bats in the belfry. Insane. Crazy. Battle axe. A woman of imposing appearance and domineering disposition. Big Butter and Egg Man, a wealthy and self-important provincial whose interests are solely commercial. Buffalo, to intimidate, to domineer. Bum steer, a piece of incorrect information or poor advice. Catch with one's pants down. To surprise in an embarrassing position or in embarrassing circumstances. Cough up one's cookies. Vomit. Funny. An object, the name of which is unknown or cannot be recalled. A great deal of silence in betwixt these terms. I think I shall continue with my authentic oddball dialogue off the cuff to behold.
Yeah.
Constabulatory to blame for a great deal of our proceedings. And you see, gotta come down Dingleside if you want to prepare thyself for one's immediate overload. Otherwise, one is ballyragged in full tune and in full constapson with one's unbiddled fiddleness, and the parnellard simply lies crusted. Okay. And one steps immediately in some Newton's brazen duster and bonfire. Oh, got itches in me britches. Bring down the wind, and ever yet lay low with one's undefined proceedings, you see. If you'll turn with me now to the 15th passage in the book of one's rusted old stones in a cigar box. It'll clearly state that one's till fountain must come up immediately overloaded by the froth of the wind. Roll me in a big pile of menudo at once and cast myself completely into the fountain of Mahatma. Sat down Waverly and Waverville.
Oh, the world is still. I know it's
I
ready to go off. The ghost of the old AOD.
Well, they broke into the house across the street. And what did they steal?
Oh, shoot, I know that. 4 and 6 cases of vinegar?
Aye. Very well, then.
Come down. Or Neptune.
I guess. Fry don't come. Or if I don't come down,
Neptune will come up.
Sun God will burn me back to the ground. Any other requests?
Yeah.
We must remember the chorus together.
Which chorus? You had a couple. Oh, the world is full. Or...
I had the whole group over at Borders singing Dillard the Buffalo all
together. Dillard the Buffalo came down from the mountain and didn't have anything in his possession. Oh, the world is filled with little brown beans. Da 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 da.
You see, I must immediately come down Dingleside. Otherwise, I will be smothered in my utility transfusion. Oh, here I stand with my utility in my hand.
You never finished that, though.
That was all there was to it.
Oh. Oh, well, the bad.